ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ नमस्ते टू ऑल ऑफ यू माइंड कंट्रोल Does it control you or you control the mind? This is a question which has been puzzling from ages. What is most important today is to understand how exactly I control the waves of the mind. Yogas Chitta Vritti Nirodha, says Maharshi Patanjali, giving a definition of yoga. Yoga is control of the waves of the mind. There are so many waves, high waves, low waves, likes and dislikes in the form of waves, happiness and sorrow in the form of waves. They are troubling you, they are troubling me, troubling everybody in the society. Crimes are caused because of the high waves, the unpurified emotions. Man becomes a slave of those emotions. Slaves of these thoughts, of the desires, of the memories. So we have to understand how exactly I have to cool the mind, how exactly I have to stabilize the mind, straighten the mind. Let us refer to the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, which is called Dhyana Yoga or Atma Sanyama Yoga. I read out the shloka, which is very, very meaningful, which is very practical, given to us, taught to us by Bhagavan Shri Krishna himself. He says, Yatha deepo nivatasto nengate sopama smrita yogino yatachittasya yunjato yogamatmanah. I repeat, Yatha deepo nivatasto nengate sopama smrita yogino yatachittasya yunjato yogamatmanah. Meaning, the flame of a lamp sheltered from wind does not flicker. Yatha deepo nivatastu. If the candle is lit in your room and the window is opened or the fan is switched on, what happens to that flame? It flickers, it may blow off. But I close the windows, I switch off the fan and protect that flame because I need it. And the output is calmness, steadiness, and the flame will be burning bright and beautiful, without flickering, without being restless. Back of me, you find two pictures, or two-in-one pictures. The yogi in meditation. There's a lamp, very bright, very steady flame. That is what Sri Krishna refers to. In fact, this shloka has been depicted in a painting form in our institute in Hyderabad. There's a second flame, which is a restless frame, which is a disturbed frame. So that is the society today. We are in the disturbed situation. I protect myself, as Sri Krishna earlier also said, Uddharet Atmanatmanam Atmanam Avasadayet Atmaiva Hyatmano Bandhu Atmaiva Ripuratmanah. He says, you are your own friend. You are your own enemy if you can control the mind, friend. If mind controls you, the enemy comes out. So, let us keep this picture in mind during our meditation. I request all of you who are watching this to keep that picture in the mind. Visualize it. Slowly, 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 gradually, 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 make the mind steady. Make the flame steady. Three places you can meditate according to Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna. He said you can meditate in Bengali, beautifully put it, Bone, Mone, Kone. You can meditate in a forest, Bone. You can meditate in Kone, in a corner of your room, in the quietude of your room. Or you can meditate in your mind itself. So that quietness is to be cultivated. It is to be practiced. So this painting that you see behind me is an ideal state of meditation. The next line Krishna is telling to us, योगिनो यतचित्तस्य युञ्जतो योगमात्मनः. This is the comparison used to describe a yogi's mind that is well under control and united with the Atman. Yogino yatachittasya yunjato yogamatmanah. He fixes it in the Atman. Normally, the mind runs behind the objects, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, touch, as we know it. But the yogi controls his sense organs and tells his mind to dive inward and fixes it in the Atman. Once it is stabilized, then the meditation will be a joy, it will be a flow, and the yogi or the meditator or the student or the professional becomes very happy. Happiness grows inside. It's an inside out concept. So try to work on this important exercise. It all depends upon abhyasa, abhyasa, abhyasa. There's no shortcut. There's no discount, there's no concession in this. Actual amount has to be paid if you need the correct object or the correct thing that you want to purchase. Similarly, pay this much and you will get the cooperation of the mind, and mind will become a wonderful instrument of joy, taking you towards joy, taking you towards happiness, taking you towards freedom, which is the goal of human life. May Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, may the Gita Acharya help us to attain that calmness and that pleasantness of a lamp in a windless place. Let us fix ourselves in the Atman and rise to glorious heights of divinity. Thank you.